بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I welcome you to another episode of our series السفرة الكرام, تجويد The Art of Reciting the Quran. I am your host Abu Ammar Yasir Qadhi. The Book of Allah Azza wa Jal is our ultimate source of guidance, our first and final reference. So great is this blessing that Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed that Allah praises Himself in the Quran because of revealing the Quran. In other words, Allah Azza wa Jal informs us that He is worthy of worship because He has revealed this book to us. In one verse, Allah Azza wa Jal says, Alhamdulillahi alladhi anzala ala abdihi alkitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise be to Allah. Why? Because He has revealed the book, the kitab, the Quran, to His servant, and He has not placed any crookedness, any misguidance in it. In yet another verse, Allah Azza wa Jal says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ. Exalted and blessed be the one who has revealed the Furqan, the criterion, to his slave, so that he may be a warner to all of mankind. In yet a third verse, Allah Azza wa Jal commands us to be happy at the revelation of the Qur'an. He commands us to rejoice, and He tells us that the Qur'an is more precious than all that this earth contains. In Surah Yunus, Allah says, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, O Muhammad, tell them that with the blessings and the mercy of Allah, the scholars of Tafsir say the blessings is the Qur'an and the mercy is Islam. So because of the Qur'an and Islam, let them rejoice, let them be happy. And verily that, meaning the Qur'an and Islam, is far better than all that they can amass and hoard of this world. So we pray that Allah Azza wa Jalla blesses us to appreciate this beauty and blessing of the Quran. In today's lesson of Tajweed, we will discuss the light and heavy letters. Remember, we were talking about the characteristics or the sifat of the letters. And so in today's lesson, we'll discuss yet another characteristic. Some letters are heavier, if you like, than other letters. And the name of these heavy letters is Tafkhim, the letters of Tafkhim. Okay, tafkhim means to make something thick or heavy. And that's why we have this diagram here, so we help you memorize it. And these type of things, by the way, they help you memorize. When you think of tafkhim, think of, let's say, flowing lava. You will think of the heaviness, the viscosity that is needed in order to pronounce these letters. So it will help you in memorizing or understanding what it is. The letters of tafkhim are the letters of isti'la as well. Same. But there are more letters of tafkhim, we'll discuss them in a little while. But the letters of isti'la, what are the letters of isti'la? Who remembers? Khussa, daght, and qidh. We have them from last episode. These are the seven letters of isti'la. These seven letters are always, always very heavy. We say in Arabic, mufakham, or characterized by tafkhim. Okay? Now let me illustrate to you what I mean by tafkhim. And the easiest way to illustrate this is to put a silent alif after the letter of tafkhim. Pronounce, for example, the kha with an alif after it. You have kha. Now pronounce it with a ba. You have ba. Notice the alif, how it gets heavier with kha versus ba. Suppose you say the word ja'a, to come. Look at how light the alif is. Ja'a. Now say the word qala, to say. Qala. Look how heavy it is. Qala versus ja'a. Because qaf is of the letters of tafkhim. Notice here, qaf is of the letters of tafkhim. Qala. Qala is heavy, deep. Versus ja'a. Look at how light the alif is. Likewise, miqatina. Look at how qa and na are characterized. Miqatina. Falamma ja'a Musa li miqatina. Look at the qa, how heavy and deep it is, and the na, how light it is. Okay, look at it in the Surah Fatiha. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ إِيَّاكَ صِرَاطَ. Look at how characterized the إِيَّاكَ is a light alif. It's not mufakham. And then the صِرَاطَ, it is going to be mufakham. So these seven letters are always heavy. Always difficult, not difficult, but rather they have a tone which is different than the tone of the other letters of the Arabic alphabet. Therefore, we say خَ versus ba, okay? Sa versus sa. Look at how even the fatha, it has this heaviness to it, which is not associated with the letters that are not of the letters of tafkhim. Now there are two letters that are occasionally heavy and occasionally light. And these are the letters of lam and ra. So we're going to discuss the rules of lam and ra in the next few episodes. These seven letters are always heavy. the lamb and the ra are sometimes heavy and sometimes light. When are they heavy, when are they light? Well, we'll discuss the lamb today. That's the easiest letter to discuss right now. The lamb, the general rule is that all lambs in the Quran are light, all of them, except in the proper name of Allah Himself. Notice when I say Allah, look at the lamb, how heavy it is. Allah. Contrast this with ilah. La ilaha illallah. Look at how lamb different. The first lamb in ilah is light. La ilaha. And the second lamb is heavy. Illallah. So the lamb will always be light except when it is in the proper name of our Creator Allah, when preceded by a fatha or dhamma. So when the name of Allah Azza wa Jal is preceded by a fatha or a dhamma, then it will be heavy. قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ اللَّهُ. Okay, قَالَ, it has a fatha on the lamb, and then Allah, the love of the Jalala, the name of our Lord, so therefore the lamb will be heavy. قَالَ اللَّهُ. Likewise, نَصْرُ اللَّهِ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ. The ra has a dhamma on it, and then the lamb of Allah comes after it, so نَصْرُ اللَّهِ, heavy. What does that leave? A kasra, obviously. So when the name of Allah is preceded by a kasra, it will not be heavy. Okay? Bismillah. We don't say Bismillah. We don't say Bismillah. Ja'a Nasrullah. Notice the difference between Bismillah and Nasrullah. The first is heavy, is light. Bismillah. And the second will be